I rise in opposition to this bill. And as I speak, I want you to, I just ask that you keep in mind that an ultrasound at 20 weeks is the ultrasound that parents will, that the woman will have that will reveal these fetal abnormalities that may be, that are so difficult and that cause this conversation. That's an ultrasound at 20 weeks. It's really important to consider that. So I want to share with you the story of a family who faced this situation. In September of 2011, Kate was a happily married mother to a 9-month-old son. When she became pregnant again, Kate and her husband were excited to have another baby. Because she had been breastfeeding, she hadn't realized she was pregnant until she was about 10 weeks along. They met with their doctor and started to schedule the normal pregnancy screenings and checkups. At their anatomy scan ultrasound, which wasn't able to be scheduled until 22 weeks, their excitement turned into worry when the nurse became very quiet. Their worry turned to shock when the doctor came in and explained that their son had no kidneys and no bladder, something known as Potter's syndrome. This anomaly is particularly devastating because, as Kate and her husband soon learned, when babies do not develop kidneys and a bladder, the lungs are unable to mature. The specialist explained to them that because he did not have mature lungs, a kidney transplant was not an option, and there was no possible way for their son to survive outside the womb. The doctor said if they wanted, he could terminate their pregnancy that day. Kate and her husband were an emotional mess and still processing all of this information. They wanted to talk to their own doctor, the doctor who delivered their first baby. So they went home, called their doctor, and did all the research that they could. Their own doctor agreed. There was nothing that could be done to save this pregnancy. For Kate and her husband, the decision to obtain abortion care was fraught with emotion, but they knew termination was the best decision for them and their family. Kate chose to have a D&E procedure as opposed to an induction because she'd had a C-section only 9 months prior, and there was a significantly greater risk of complications with an induction. With a 9-month-old son at home, Kate knew she needed to protect her health so that she could continue being a mother to her son. Once Kate and her husband had decided to move forward with the D&E procedure, they sought care from a doctor at a nearby university hospital. The staff sat with Kate and her husband and answered all of the questions they could think of, providing the comfort and support they needed. After Kate had obtained her procedure safely and without complications, she and her family were able to heal and begin to move forward together. A few months later, Kate was pregnant again with a third boy. Thank you, Mr. Speaker.